Well, good morning. Welcome to all. It's good to see you all here this day. As the service goes along, just pretty much follow along with it. I ask you to just kind of go with it, and I think you'll find that there's a lot in common with this as to what we are in our daily lives. Now, I'm a little bit challenged when it comes to directions. Even when I have a compass, somebody asks me which way north is, I just go like that. So I think for clarity at this time, it's hard to tell with the way 41 runs, but I'm going to say that's north, and that would be south. Of course, then we have east and west, so in our prayer here, opening prayer, we will all face that way. And we'll begin by all facing the center, so let us begin worship. Creator is the center of creation. The central reality of Creator's plan for the world is the central reality of our lives. As we face each of the four directions, as we kneel to Mother Earth, as we reach to the heavens, we will respond in prayer. Following each prayer, we will return to face the center, reminded each time that it is our brother who is able to bring healing and salvation, and who, by his Holy Spirit, is able to renew the face of the earth. I'd ask you all to rise and face the center point at this time if you were able. The start of life's journey, the new day, is the east. It is the place of beginnings, first light, and the possibility of starting again. You have sung us into existence. Let us face east. And let us pray. Enable us, Creator Spirit, to be wise in our use of the resources of the earth, sharing them in justice, partaking of them in thankfulness. The South holds the warmth of summer. It is a time of innocence, of learning and growth. You have sung us into existence. Let us face south. And let us pray. May we walk. The West reminds us of the wisdom of maturity with the approaching of the sunset. It is a time of parenthood, responsibility, and good sense, the time to teach, acknowledge, and give thanks. You have sung us into existence. Let us now face West and pray that the Spirit of Creator may again breathe over the waters, making them pure, making them fruitful. Let us pray. We pray that we may
be purified so that life may be sustained and nurtured over the entire face of the earth.
The North holds the hard, cleansing wisdom of time of winter and white hair. The elders breathe through the sacred pipe, the grandparents who, on life's great circle, are closest to the little children. You have sung us into existence. Let us face north. And let us pray. May the air we breathe be purified,
so that life may be sustained and nurtured over the entire face of the earth.
From Mother Earth comes all that has life. You have sung us into existence. Let us kneel or symbolically touch Mother Earth and let us pray. May we walk gently upon the earth
and leave our footprints softly on what we touch.
We raise our hands toward the Father Sky in love. Father Sky embraces all the earth with his love. You have sung us into existence. Let us raise our hands to Father Sky and pray. May we see the vastness of your arms and feel your embrace of love at all times. Aho, amen. Our opening hymn is number 650. Great Spirit, look at our brokenness. We know that in all
creation, the human family has strayed from the sacred way, the way of love, respect, gratitude, and reverence for all life. We know that we are the ones who are divided, and we are the ones who must come back together to walk the sacred way, the way of love, respect, gratitude, and reverence for all life. Sacred One, teach us love, compassion, and honor, that we may heal the earth and heal each other.
As surely as the rain comes forth to water the earth, God's mercy comes to us as a gift, abundant and freely given. The same God who created the cosmos and raised Jesus from death to life brings healing and forgiveness to the world today. You are loved, you are restored. In Christ, you are made new. Aho, amen. Please join in the hymn of praise.
Dwell with
Please all join me in the prayer of the day. O great Creator, we come before you in a humble manner. We pray for all our relations in nature, all those who walk, crawl, fly, and swim, seen and unseen, and to the good spirits that exist in every part of creation. May there be beauty above us. May there be beauty below us. May there be beauty in us and beauty all around us. We ask that this world be filled with peace, love, and beauty. Aho. Amen. God of abundance, the land we walk on is holy ground. Send forth your grace to help us heal the wounds of this world. Open up the soil of our hearts to your word of life.
May we be strengthened by this time together and grow into who you created us to be.
The first reading today comes from the book of Daniel, 7th chapter. As I watched, thrones were set in place, and an ancient one took his throne. His clothing was white as snow, and the hair of his head like pure wool. His throne was fiery flames, and its wheels were burning fire. A stream of fire issued and flowed out from his presence. 1,000,000 served him, and 10,000 times 10,000 stood attending him. The court sat in judgment, and the books were opened. As I watched in the night visions, I saw one like a human being coming with the clouds of heaven. And he came to the Ancient One and was presented before him. To him was given dominion and glory and kingship, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion and shall not pass away, and his kingship is one that shall never be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Today we're using tone number 1 on page 337. Here's the refrain for today. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. Let's sing that together.
Ever since the world began, your throne has been established.
The Lord is King, robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. The Lord has made the world so sure that it cannot be moved.
Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established.
The waters have lifted up, O Lord, the waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves.
Mightier than the sound of many waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea.
Mightier is the Lord who dwells on high. Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness befits your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore.
Ever since the world began, your throne has been established.
Our second reading this morning is from first chapter of Revelation. Grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood and made us to be a kingdom, priests serving his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds. Every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And on his account, all the tribes of the earth will wail. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The words of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'd ask you to rise as you're able for the Gospel of St. John, the 18th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" And Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" And Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who believes or belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of our Lord. So let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, you looked over a formless void and breathed life into it, bringing about the beauty of this creation. In the beginning was the Word that was God, and all things came into being through him, a light for all peoples. May this light shine so brightly that we cannot miss that your love is for all peoples. Let our voices speak for those who have not been listened to, and to move for those who have been restrained. Make us instruments of your peace and reconciliation, reaching out to all of creation. In Jesus' name, amen. My dear friends in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord Jesus. Amen. As you know, I have just returned from a very successful hunting trip. Now, many make sure then that they've, since I've declared this, that I've had this successful hunting trip, they'll ask me, "How large a deer did you happen to drag out of that woods?" Well, the answer is, I didn't harvest one. But that doesn't mean that I failed, unless the focus was purely about harvesting a deer. Now, you know, I guess it could be said, in light of how I look at fishing, you know, if you're out in your boat and you haven't caught a fish yet, well, you're not fishing, you're just boating. So in that light, I would say, if I were to say I was out deer hunting, I'd have to say, well, no, I was just out hiking and camping, because that's what I had done. So maybe my success was indeed the fact that I was able to enjoy what was going on. You know, being in that big woods has its own rewards. I was able to climb steep hills again. I didn't think I would a few years ago, but thankfully, the Lord has provided a way for me, even when it seems like there's no way longer to go, to reach out and grab a little branch and pull myself up just a little bit farther until I was able to make the top. Hopefully, I'll be able to continue to do that, but who knows? It was a workout. But it was awesome that I was able to do that. And when I got to the top of those huge hills, the view was simply spectacular. I was able to see, as I was tromping about that woods, the beginning of the swamps that turn into little trickles of creeks that then turn into streams that finally flow into what would have been, in my case, the Ontonagon River. It was awesome to see those things. And other wildlife certainly was there to see. Bobcat was out and about. There were rabbits all over the place. I saw a grouse. And there were several types of songbirds out and about. Of course, there's always our friendly little chickadee. But the one that I thought that was really odd, I would have figured had already migrated to the Southlands. But apparently, there was still enough abundant food in the forests for that young bird to stay put. It was really quite awesome. All in all, I would say that that trip was very successful. It was very renewing and refreshing. A success by any means. Now, much of our focus, though, coming up on this week that we're in right now, will be on the Thanksgiving holiday. And I expect that what will come to our minds will be our comfort foods, our favorite stuff that we save for this Thanksgiving feast. We'll be gathering with family and friends, perhaps this year, which will be quite a blessing over what it might have been last year. Hopefully all will go well and all of that, and we will be able to gather together and share what we all have to be thankful for. For all the great gifts that have been poured upon us. And I would like us to also remember then that all these many years ago, I'd ask you to recall a piece of our history on this Thanksgiving feast, where those first colonists most certainly would have died had not the Creator had indigenous peoples in place here in the Americas that came to their rescue with the abundance that God had poured upon the earth at that time. Yes, we have much to be thankful for, and then all that we can do in our lives. But today we also see in our readings a time of reflection upon, number one, Christ as our King. But I think what we see here in our early reading in Daniel, it's this message that has been delivered to the oppressed. These people were captives. They were asked to give up their livelihoods. They were asked not to worship the way that they had been accustomed to all their lives. They were told that they were no longer able to do that, that they would have to give their holiness to a king that they did not observe. It's sad how we can hold people down like that and prohibit them from doing that which comes natural to them. But we have done it. But the book of Daniel reminds us that the judge will indeed send someone in the form of man who will come to save us all, who will bring good news to everyone, who will indeed set us all free. Now, here in the United States, we probably have a hard time recognizing kingship among us. I mean, after all, in the 1700s, wasn't that partially what the Independence War was about? Was to release us from the rule of the king. But we're asked on this day to recognize our true king. We hear in the story of Revelation of this king that is to come, the one who will, if you read through the story farther, make all things new here on earth, that all things will be restored, that peace and love will be that which conquers everything. We continue on and we hear in this Gospel of John of our King that has been delivered to us, our Savior, Jesus the Christ, the one who has come to release us from the bondages of sin, the one who has come to let us know what real freedom is, not the stuff that we think it is as we look about our political ideals in this country, but what real freedom is. Free from that which holds us down. Free from oppression. Free to be able to worship our Creator. Free to acknowledge Christ as King. This Jesus the Christ comes into our lives so that we all may be made whole once again. And he comes to all of creation, just as it was written in Daniel, and just as it was written in Revelation, that Christ comes for all peoples, that all are restored, that all are made new once again, that creation is restored to its original meanings. Yes, today we celebrate the fact that we have been given life by our Creator God, and that Jesus the Christ is indeed King and rules over that life for us. Amen.
Redeem your whole creation.
share our humanity, to set before us the paths of life and death, and walk them with us, to be rejected and die, but finally to conquer death and a new life, draw the world to himself for all time. We believe in Creator, indwelling Spirit, who calls us into community, that we may, through faith in that community of oneness, experience uplifting and sustaining grace, that we may fulfill our human responsibility to reach out to our neighbor, whomever that may be, that we may rejoice in the constant nature of creation and the wondrous joy of life itself. We believe in the Creator, whose word teaches us that all things grow together, the circle of life, that the paths of life and death, good and evil, to all come together, that choices are not clearly defined, but that we confidently and responsibly tread the path we choose, and only the true one can be our judge. We believe in Creator, who is present and working in this world through all creation. Ahoho. Amen. So all is sacred.
All is sacred.
Every part of the earth is sacred.
Every shining pine needle, every sandy shore,
every mist of the dark woods,
every clearing in the sacred soil,
the rocky crust, the juices of the meadows, the beasts and all people.
All belong to the same family.
Teach your children that the earth is our mother.
Whatever befalls the earth, befalls the children of the earth.
The waters murmur as the voice of our father's father.
We are part of the earth, and the earth is part of us.
The rivers are our brothers. They quench our thirst.
The
air is precious.
For all of us share the same breath.
The wind that gave our grandparents breath also received their last sigh.
The wind gave our children spiritual life and will continue.
This we know. The earth does not belong to us.
We belong to the earth.
This we know. All things are connected.
Like the blood which makes me from me.
All things are connected.
Our God is the same God, whose compassion is equal for all.
We did not weave the web of life.
We are merely suspending it.
Whatever we do to the web,
we do to ourselves.
Let us give thanks to the web in the circle that connects us.
Thanks be to Creator. Loving and forgiving God, we acknowledge that our part is filled, that our past is filled with scars that inflicted upon indigenous people to attend boarding school in which they were robbed of their identity, and that the legacy continues through the generations. You invite us to heal this broken history by living as different people today and into our future, as we seek to learn what it means to walk together. Give us courage to confess and own what is ours so that our journey is healing. God, in your mercy. Lord of justice and consolation, as Rachel wept for her children, we grieve the deaths of all indigenous peoples who have been murdered over the years. We pray for families who miss their loved ones. Console all who mourn. We pray also for those who are missing and may still be found, for those who hang on to hope in the midst of profound despair. Console all who mourn, for all those who have been wounded by senseless acts of violence. Bring justice to those who cry out. Remember your beloved children as you remember you. God, in your mercy. Recognizing the harm done to generations of indigenous people in church and state, we, your people, seek forgiveness. O God, in the spirit of your Son, to walk alongside native people as neighbors on the earth you've given us to share. Help them to see us in us an expression of your love and justice. God, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray that the indigenous people of northern Wisconsin and upper Michigan, whether living on or off reservation, may be healed of their deep wounds, reclaim the gifts of their cultural state heritage, and have access to a good education and productive employment. Particularly, we pray for our neighbors in the Keweenaw Bay Indian Community, the Bay Mills Indian Community, the Sault Ste. Marie Tribe of Chippewa Indians, Lockview Desert, Band of Lake Superior Chippewa Indians, Hannahville Indian Community, Little Traverse Bay Bands of Ottawa Indians, Lac du Flambeau Band of Lake Superior Chippewa Indians, Sakogan Chippewa Community, Mole Lake Band of Lake Superior Chippewa Indians. God, in your mercy. Jesus Christ, Holy Child of God, you have prayed for us with your Spirit that intercedes for us. Hear our prayers. Help us to command our worries and fears to you. In you, our hope arises, and we look for the new life, what you alone can bring. In the name of Jesus Christ, the risen one, we lift our prayers.
Amen.
Great Spirit, whose wigwam is in the sky and hunting ground is the earth, all are afraid of. You and mighty are you called, ruler over storms, over people, and birds, and beasts, and mountains. Have your way over all, over earthways and skyways. Find us this day our meat and corn, that we may be strong and brave, and put aside from us wicked ways, as we put aside the bad of all peoples. And let us not have that lead into crooked paths, but keep everyone in our circle from all danger. For yours is all that is, the earth and sky, the streams, the hills, the valleys, the stars, the moon and the sun, all that lives and has breath, all that has your life and spirit within. Wonderful, shining, mighty Spirit, Amen.
The peace of our brother Jesus be with you always.
And also with you.
Please find a way to share that peace. Indigenous peoples offer tobacco as a gift to the Creator. One of the four sacred herbs, tobacco,
along with cedar, sweetgrass, and sage, is a powerful gift that is pleasing to our Creator and a symbol of respect.
Therefore, in our traditional way,
let us offer our gifts, our resources, our love to Creator.
Please join me in the prayer. Thank you, Creator, for all that you have given us. Thank you for the beauty of the universe that you created, the trees, the sky, the mountains, the rain. All things hold beauty in themselves and are related and touch each creatures of the earth. You created the rhythm and patterns of the universe in a harmony of movement, sight, and sound. Help us to appreciate your creation and to live in our eyes, ears, and hearts open to your message. Aho. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, We praise your name and join their unending hymn. Mighty and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who, on the cross, opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he gave thanks. He took the cup and he gave it to all, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Morning, morning.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray then. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Walk tall as the trees, live strong as the mountains. Be gentle as the spring winds. Keep the warmth of the summer sun in your heart, and the great spirit will always be with you. Aho. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit that makes us one. Well, I left my announcements up on the pew up there, so I guess I'm just going to have to say they are as are printed. 6:30 Tuesday, there will be a Thanksgiving service, ecumenical one held at Emanuel out on the highway there. If you can't make it and you want to still see it, I think they'll have a live broadcast on that one, I believe he is, so. Have to check his website to see what that is. Anyway, are there any other announcements for this day? Wow, okay. Well, when we see the changes of day and night, the stars in the sky, we realize
it is the work of someone more powerful than humans.
Go in peace and make peace.
Remembering the cross of Christ again.